Have you ever wondered what would happen if space was filled with air? In our daily lives, we're surrounded by an ocean of air, a mix of gases that we breathe in and out without a second thought. But as we venture beyond the confines of our planet, we encounter a vastly different environment, the vacuum of space. It's an expanse of infinite emptiness, devoid of the air we find so essential. Space is not a complete vacuum, but it's pretty close. It's sparsely populated with a few hydrogen and helium atoms here and there, but for the most part, it's an endless void. It's so empty that sound, which requires a medium like air or water to travel through, cannot be transmitted. That's why in space, no one can hear you scream, or even whisper for that matter. This lack of air also has implications for temperature regulation. Here on Earth, our atmosphere helps distribute heat, keeping our planet at a comfortable average temperature. But in space, with no air to carry away heat or bring in cold, temperatures can swing wildly between extreme heat and extreme cold. What's stopping space from being filled with air, you might ask? The answer lies in the force of gravity. Our Earth, with its considerable mass, has enough gravitational pull to hold on to its atmosphere, preventing it from drifting off into space. But once you get past a certain point, known as the Kármán line, Earth's gravitational pull becomes too weak to hold on to the air, and it escapes into the vacuum of space. It's a fascinating thought experiment, isn't it? A universe where the vacuum of space is replaced by an expanse of air. It would certainly make space travel a lot different, and potentially a lot more noisy. But before we get too carried away with the idea, let's take a step back and consider the physics of such a universe. Imagine, for a moment, that all of this emptiness was filled with air. To understand the implications of an air-filled universe, we first need to delve into some basic physics. Let's start with the relationship between air and temperature. Air is a gas, and gases have an interesting characteristic. They expand when heated and contract when cooled. This is the principle behind hot air balloons, where heated air expands, becomes less dense than the surrounding cooler air, and thus rises. Now let's talk about sound transmission. Sound travels as waves through a medium, such as air or water. In the vacuum of space, there's no medium for sound waves to travel through, which is why it's often said that in space, no one can hear you scream. But if the universe were filled with air, it would provide a medium for sound waves to travel, potentially allowing us to hear cosmic events like supernovas or colliding galaxies. Finally, let's touch on gravity. Gravity is the force that shapes atmospheres around celestial bodies. It pulls gas molecules, like those in air, towards the center of mass. This is why we have an atmosphere on Earth. Our planet's gravity pulls air molecules towards its surface. However, in the vastness of space, where there's no dominant source of gravity, gases would be evenly spread out rather than forming atmospheres around celestial bodies. So what does all this mean for our hypothetical air-filled universe? Well, with air acting as a medium, we'd be able to hear the cosmos. However, the constant expansion and contraction of air due to cosmic temperature fluctuations could create chaotic conditions. And without a dominant gravitational source, air wouldn't form atmospheres around planets. Instead, it would be evenly dispersed throughout the universe. Now, with these basics in mind, let's explore the consequences of a universe full of air. So, what would happen to Earth if space was filled with air? A fascinating question indeed. Let's delve into the possibilities. Firstly, our planet's atmosphere would blend seamlessly with the air-filled cosmos, effectively erasing the boundary between Earth and space. This would drastically impact our climate. The sun's rays would be diffused throughout the cosmic air, making our world significantly colder. The constant, unfiltered barrage of solar radiation could also result in heightened levels of harmful ultraviolet light reaching the Earth's surface, affecting all forms of life. The Earth's rotation, too, would be affected. The friction between the planet and the cosmic air would slow down our planet's spin. This would lengthen our days and nights, and over time, possibly even cause our planet to become tidally locked with the sun, where one side faces the sun perpetually, while the other remains in darkness. The effects wouldn't be limited to Earth. All planets in our solar system would experience similar changes. For instance, Mars, with its thin atmosphere, would now be enveloped in a sea of cosmic air. This could potentially lead to the formation of an Earth-like climate, making Mars a more hospitable place. On the flip side, the gas giants like Jupiter and Saturn would be significantly altered. The additional air could compress their atmospheres, increasing their density and possibly even changing their compositions. And here's an intriguing twist. If space was filled with air, it would carry sound. Imagine being able to hear the roar of the sun, the creaking of cosmic bodies, or the symphony of distant stars. However, this isn't as delightful as it sounds. The constant noise could be deafening, and our planet, along with others, would be continuously bombarded by sound waves, leading to constant vibrations. The effects of this are hard to predict, but it's safe to say that it would be a cacophony like no other. But what about the rest of the universe, you ask? Well, that's a tale for another time. For now, let's revel in the strange, yet fascinating idea of a universe filled with air. With air filling the universe, the cosmos as we know it would be fundamentally different. Let's start with stars. The birth, life, and death of stars are a delicate dance of gravity and nuclear forces. But if space was filled with air, this balance would be severely disrupted. Stars form in the densest parts of space, where gravity pulls gas and dust together. But if all of space was filled with air, the uniform density might prevent stars from forming at all. And if stars did manage to form, they'd burn through their fuel much faster, leading to shorter lifespans and more frequent supernovae. Galaxies, too, would be significantly impacted. The spiral arms of galaxies, like our Milky Way, are formed due to differences in density and the gravitational interactions of stars. If space was filled with air, these density differences would be smoothed out, potentially preventing the formation of galaxies as we know them. Now let's turn our attention to light, the messenger of the universe. Light from distant stars and galaxies travels millions, even billions of years to reach us. In an air-filled universe, this light would be scattered and absorbed, just like sunlight is diffused on a foggy day. We might only be able to see nearby stars, and the beautiful nebulae and galaxies we're familiar with would be lost in a diffuse glow. The formation of celestial bodies would also be fundamentally changed. Planets form from the dust and gas left over after a star is born. But with air everywhere, the process of planetary formation might be completely different, possibly leading to a universe filled with entirely different types of planets. In essence, an air-filled universe would be a much more chaotic place. The orderly structures we see today, from the stars in the sky to the galaxies in the cosmos, would be replaced by a universe in constant flux, with stars burning out rapidly and light scattered in every direction. The universe filled with air is indeed a fascinating yet chaotic concept. So, would an air-filled universe be a better one? This is the question we've been exploring, and the answer is, not quite. We've examined the immensity of space and the physics behind an air-filled cosmos. We've investigated the consequences for Earth and other planets, and even envisioned the universe in a new light. Each aspect, each perspective, has led us to one conclusion. If space were filled with air, the universe would be a drastically different place. The physics we've come to understand would be turned on its head, potentially leading to a universe unrecognizable to us. The twinkling stars that we gaze upon from Earth's surface would be obscured by an atmospheric haze, transforming our night sky into a murky abyss. Moreover, the planets as we know them would likely cease to exist. The Earth, our home, would be subjected to immense friction as it moved through this air-filled space, causing it to heat up to unbearable temperatures. It's a scenario that paints a picture of a universe inhospitable to life as we know it. In addition, the speed of light would be affected, altering the way we perceive the universe. The beautiful, distant galaxies we observe would be blurred or completely hidden from sight, taking away the awe-inspiring spectacle that is our cosmos. Furthermore, the air itself would pose a problem. The immense gravitational forces at play in the universe would cause the air and space to clump together around celestial bodies, creating enormous, dense spheres of gas and potentially leading to a series of catastrophic events. So, while the thought of an air-filled universe might seem intriguing, the reality would be far from idyllic. The vacuum of space, as it turns out, is not just an empty void. It's a crucial component of our universe, one that allows stars to shine, planets to exist, and life to flourish. As we can see, the vacuum of space is not just an empty void, but a fundamental aspect of the universe as we know it.